Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon, okay. Sir.
Good afternoon. Okay, so one thing.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon. Yesterday I didn't get time to upload your theoretical PPT. Okay, so today I am very busy right now because I have back-to-back 3 classes from 3 p.m. Okay, so tomorrow I will upload all the study materials. Okay. So okay, till okay, so yesterday I discussed one numerical, right? Based on your other theorems. Okay. So yes, some of you have given the answers in group, but I didn't get any time to check all those. Okay. So I hope tomorrow I will get time. And let me check what was that numerical. Oh, yes. I have that numerical right now. Let's check whether you are doing the right answer or not. Okay, just a minute.
Sir, some students, sir, I think.
Yes.
Some students, sir, I think.
Yes, I know. Just a minute. Okay. Okay, so let me share the screen first. Okay, is the screen visible to everyone? Just wait some.
Yes, sir.
Okay, very good. That means.
Yes, sir.
This is also visible. Right. This one is also visible to you. Okay, so what was the previous problem?
So, not visible.
Just give some time. Okay, is it visible now?
No, sir.
No, sir.
No, sir.
Okay, now is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
A black screen,
yes, sir.
In front of,
yes,
you.
Sir.
Okay, very good. So this was your previous day's problem. Do it very quickly. Okay, if you have that copy where you solved it, take that copy and tell me the answers quickly. Okay. And all of you are participating in that contest, right? Hello, am I audible to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
And are you participating all those contests that the poster was already given in your group, right?
So which contest, sir?
Okay, there was one part. Yes, sir. Hardware club. Exactly, hardware club.
Yes, sir.
Good. Yes, because I am telling this because regarding that hardware club, if you got any place or if you have any position like first, second or third, then you will get one certificate and that certificate will be useful for your mark points. Okay, mandatory points. Okay, so that's what I am telling you. Yes.
Photography quiz and etc.
That one.
Yes, obviously that one.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Okay. So this one is the superposition theorem. Using superposition theorem, you have to find out the current flowing through this 5 ohm. Okay. So there are two sources. So when 15 volt source is used, this is your 15 volt source. This is your 4 ohm. This is your 2 ohm. And this portion will be open circuit. Okay. This one will be 3. In series, it will be 5. Okay. So total, it will be 8 ohm. I am writing here 8 ohm. Okay. This one is 4. This one is your 2. This one is your 15 volt. Okay, this one is connected. Don't think it like open circuit. Now, how much current is flowing through this path? Use your simple nodal analysis. This voltage is suppose V at this point. Already I discussed this one in previous class. So incoming current is 15 minus V by 4. Your outgoing current is this, because this one is reference volt, that means 0 volt. So V minus 0 by 2 plus V by 8, because the same current will flow through the 3 ohm and 5 ohm. Okay, now, so I can write here that 15 by 4, right? I can write here 15 by 4 equals to V into 8. I am doing one step jump, okay? I have converted the side change. I have done the side change, that minus V by 4 to the right hand side. That will be plus V by 4. So it will be 2 plus 4 plus 1. So that means 4 plus 2, 6 plus 1, 7 by 8. Okay, 4, 8, it will be cancelled. So your V value is 30 by 7. Okay, are you getting this one?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Very good. Now, this V voltage is this, and how much current will flow through this path? The current I L dash. This value will be 30 by 7 divided by 8. Okay. So that means it will be your 15 divided by 28. 15 divided by 28. Yes. Is that okay to you?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Fine. Now, the second part we are doing, we are considering only the 6 ampere. So now you have to draw the circuit again. Voltage source will be shorted. Clear? Now, this one is your 4. This one is your 2. So don't get confused between 4 and 2, because 4 ohm and 2 ohm are connected in parallel, not in series. Because look, if you are going from this point, you have two paths, one this, another one this. Okay. Right? Okay, just a minute. Okay, is the screen visible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, this 4 ohm is here. Just a minute. Okay, 4 ohm is present here, 2 ohm is here, and they are connected in parallel fashion. Okay. Here, 6 ampere is present. One is your 6 ampere, and here this one is your 8 ohm. Okay,
This is your 8 ohm. So 4 and 2 are in parallel. So I am redrawing this circuit because I am going to apply the current divider rule. Okay. So 4 and 2, if parallel, then 4 into 2 divided by 4 plus 2. So that will be 8 by 6. 8 by 6 means 4 by 3. So this will be your 4 by 3 ohm. This one will be 6 ampere. Okay. And this is your 8 ohm. Now, as per our current divider rule, okay, and no need to give your attendance right now because I will share the your Google form. Okay, you will fill up that Google form automatically. Attendance will be recorded. Okay, so no need to give your attendance in the chat box. After the end of the class, I will share. Okay, and that will remain, that will accept your responses till 10 minutes. So be active. Now, this one will be your IL double dash. Okay, so now I am going to calculate the IL double dash. The value is your 6 ampere into IL double dash here in 8 ohm. So we are considering 4 by 3 as in numerator. 4 by 3 divided by 4 by 3 plus 8. That means 6 here, this 3 and this 3 will be cancelled out. So 8 into 3, that will be 24. 24 plus 4, it will be 28. So 4, 28. So this will be your 6 by 7. Now look at the current direction every time. Here the current direction is downward. Here the current direction is also downward. So total current will be the addition IL. Okay, this will be 15 by 28 plus 6 by 7. So this will be nothing but the 7, 4, 28, 6, 4, 24. So it will be what? 39 by 28. Okay, this one value you are getting or not? Check everyone.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So yes, sir.
Using this superposition theorem and just applying your nodal analysis concept, you can calculate the current easily. And the main problem is in Norton circuit. Why? Because there you have to calculate the short circuit current. But that short circuit current calculation, sometimes it becomes very tricky, just like I showed you in previous example. Okay, where the you have to check the voltage, 0 volt, 0 volt, then you have to calculate the current. And if dependent source is present in the circuit, then take extra care. Okay, so with this, just a minute. So with this, the theorem concept is over. Right, now we are going to learn the last topic of the circuit of the this chapter. Okay, superposition theorem already over, and now this one. Okay, RL series circuit. Okay, is the screen visible to everyone?
Respond. Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So actually, sir, what is the main concept in RL series circuit? In case of RL series circuit, if you connect in our lab, your offline classes will start very soon. No need to worry. I will explain all the details. Whatever you are studying in theoretical part, the 90% things will be matched in practical. Okay. What will be this 10 in between 10%? That is due to error. Okay. Now, what is the RL series circuit? RL series circuit means, suppose this is your voltage, okay, 10 volt. This one is your resistance. So just by doing V by R, you can calculate the current, how much current is flowing. Okay. Now, in this world, in this human world, whatever where you construct, that wire has some inbuilt inductance. Okay, anywhere that cannot be free of inductance, only if you have some superconductor. Clear? So this resistor has some inbuilt inductance, and that inbuilt inductance is drawn by normal inductor sign. Okay. Now, what happens due to this presence of this inductance, when you see the curve, that means you have the voltmeter, you have ammeter, you will see due to the presence of this inductor, the current is not maximum from the starting time. It will gradually increase. That means it will gradually increase. This type of waveform you will get if you plot the points. Okay, this is your I with respect to time. If L is present, L is present. Okay, so why this is happening? Because what is this inductor's property? The inductor's property is to oppose the rate of change of this inductor. What is the main concept? The main concept is when the current is passing through the inductor, a voltage will be developed, and that voltage is directly proportional to the rate of change of current, and its direction will be opposite. Okay, that's why we are writing V equals to, or VL. VL equals to minus L di by dt. But since this is a DC circuit, okay, since this is one DC circuit, the inductor will not act. Okay, so you will see that in ideal case, the curve will look like this, because inductor will not work. But in practical case, the curve looks like this one. Okay, so this difference, this much small difference, is due to the presence of inductor. So that is the concept of RL series circuit. Okay. And this one is called the transient analysis. Okay, this one is called TRANSIENT, transient analysis. Okay, because the current value is gradually increasing from time zero to time infinity. Okay, in ideal case, inductor will not work. It will work as a short circuit. Why? Because rate of change of current is zero. But in real case, that is not possible at all. So that's why you will get this difference from the axis. Okay. So this deviation or this difference is due to the presence of inductance in that wire. Okay. Now, you may have seen that if you have seen that bulb. Okay. In that bulb, the filament is made of some coils. Okay. That coil, or if you have seen some heater, that coil
that coil will also work as the inductor because it has some inductance property. Okay, nowhere is free from the inductance. Right, so here we are going to construct the equation, or we are going to calculate, better saying, we are going to calculate the I value. Okay, since inductor is present and we are talking about the real time values, so I value we are going to calculate, that is with respect to time, because see that I value is changing with respect to time. Okay, so concept clear hua sabke liye? Sabka concept clear hua? RL series circuit kati hai, what kaise karta hai? How is it working?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So, how are we going to calculate this one? Very simple. First, you have the switch. Close the switch. Now, this one is your R. This one is your L, inductor. And this one is your source. Okay. Your DC source here. In ideal case, I am repeatedly telling, in ideal case, inductor will not work. Why? Because rate of change of current is zero. So voltage developed will be zero. That means the inductor will work as a short-circuited path. But here, since we are not talking about ideal case, we are talking about real time. Okay, what is happening in reality? Then we are going to calculate the current where inductor is present. Okay, now look here, I is flowing. Okay, now since I is flowing, how much voltage will be developed across this resistor? Tell me, what is the voltage developed across the resistor? This one value is R. That is V equals to IR. So we are writing here VR, the voltage drop across the R, across the resistor, is I into R. Okay. Now, in case of this inductor, VL will be L into di dt, right? Because here we are considering that I is changing. Now, so now construct the equation. This one is our source and this one is our drop, vr plus vl. So your equation will look like this. Okay, here instead of capital I, here it is written as small I, because we are considering that the small I, that is a function of t, is flowing through the circuit. Okay, and I is the maximum current that will flow. Okay, so instead of writing capital I, we are writing here small I. So that's why here we need to write small I. Okay, because here small I is varying with respect to t. Okay, but capital I is the maximum current that will flow through this circuit. Okay, now we are going to integrate this equation and we are going to calculate the I value. Okay, so first we did what? IR will be taken in left hand side. It will be minus IR equals to LDI dt, and then dt will be one side and other portion will be kept in another side. Then integrate both side, and before that take common this L by R. Okay, so this portion, this equation you are getting, right? Then integrate both side. So integration of dt, clear, and equals to L by R integration of di by Vs by R minus I. Okay, is this construction clear to everyone? If not, then ask. Hello, is this portion clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, yes. Fine. So now this Vs minus I, this portion is written as Z. So you have studied the substitute. The substitute, right? So this portion, this denominator portion is substituted by the Z. Okay, substitution process in integration. I hope you learned that in 11-12 mathematics. So then di will be minus dz, clear? Then put here the dt by L by R equals to integration dz by minus z. Okay, now after integration of dt, it will be t, and here it will be minus ln z. Ln means log e base z. Log e base z. And this k is our constant. Okay, now in the place of z, put the value. Okay, and look, instead of this L by R, here written another term that is called tau. Okay, another Greek letter, it is called tau. This is called the time constant, L by R. It is called the time constant of the circuit. Okay, you have learned a new term, that is time constant. Because this time constant defines the circuit, that what is the circuit, how is the circuit, how will the circuit work. Okay, if we give the source voltage, then how will that circuit work? That will be seen, that will be identified by the time constant, that is tau. Okay, now t equals t by tau equals to minus of ln Vs by R minus I plus k. Okay, this one is, I think, okay to everyone. This one is very simple integration and substitution. Okay, next we are going to consider, we are going to take some assumption. Now, first draw the circuit. This one is your original circuit. Okay, this is your inductor and this one is your voltage. Okay, now look, if you haven't on this switch, you have, if you did not close this switch, the current will not flow. So at time t equals to zero, you are going to close this switch. That means at that time the current is not flowing, correct? So at that time, when at t equals to zero, when you are going to close this switch, close this S switch, at that time, the current flowing through the circuit is zero. Okay, so now place t equals to zero and I equals to zero. From this condition, calculate what is the value of K. Okay. So we will get as ln Vs by R. Okay, that is log E base Vs by R equals to K. Now put that value in the original equation, this equation. Okay. Now, after simplification, you will get one final equation, that is I equals to Vs by R into 1 minus t by tau. So look here, the I, whatever you are getting, this I, it is a function of T. With respect to time, the current is changing. Right. Now, tell me one thing. If this value, T value, equals to zero, what will be the I value you are getting from this equation? Tell me.
Sir,
one. Zero, sir. Who is telling one? Why? Why you have thought something? That's why you are telling me that this value is one. Why this is
yes.
one?
Yes, sir. Because e to the power t by tau. No? Here.
Yes. Yes. So that means. Yes, this one will be e to the power 0. So e to yes, the power sir. 0 equals to 1. So 1 minus 1 equals to 0. So I value is 0.
0, yes.
Is that okay?
Sorry.
Okay, no issue. We all do mistakes. Okay, but learn from that mistake. Clear? So yes, this one is your 0 ampere. Right? Now, if you put the value t equals to infinite, then what I value you are getting? Tell me. If you are putting this t equals to infinite, what will be the value of I?
It will depend upon Vs upon R.
Exactly. This value will be Vs by R. So look, at that time when T equals to infinity, at that time the circuit current, the current that is flowing through the circuit is not depending on L. Then what does it mean? It means at time T tends to infinity or T equals to infinity, the circuit will be a completely resistive circuit. The inductor will be shorted. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Concept clear हुआ? देखो, ये total चीज DC के साथ match कर रहा है, क्योंकि DC में हम लोग क्या पढ़े थे? कि इंडक्टर काम नहीं करेगा. दैट मींस इंडक्टर विल बी शॉर्टेड. बट लुक हियर, व्हेन टी टेंड्स टू इनफिनिटी, व्हाटएवर करंट इज फ्लोइंग दैट इज मैचिंग. दिस वन इज वीएस, दिस वन इज आर. सो व्हाट करंट इज फ्लोइंग? वीएस बाय आर. बट हियर इंडक्टर इज प्रेजेंट बट इट इज नॉट वर्किंग. व्हाई? इट बिकम्स शॉर्ट सर्किटेड, जस्ट लाइक द कंसेप्ट ऑफ डीसी. ओके, is that clear? Clear hua na sab?
Yes, sir.
Okay, very
yes,
good.
Yes, sir.
So now we are going to calculate the voltage across the inductor. So what is the voltage across the inductor? VL equals to L di dt. Now put the value of I. That means L into dt of Vs by R into 1 minus e to the power minus t by tau. Okay, what is the value of tau? Tau equals to L by R. This is called time constant. Okay. Now, after this differentiation, what you are getting? This, since Vs by R all are constant, so it will go outside. Okay. 1, that is also constant. So after differentiation, it will be 0. And e to the power minus t by tau, differentiation is 1 by tau into e to the power minus t by tau. So look here, what is tau? Tau is nothing but L by R. So R will be on top, right? So this R will be cancelled out. This L will be cancelled out. So ultimately you are getting what? Vs into e to the power minus t by tau. So look, Vs is also a function of t. Okay. Now, if you put t equals to 0, or t equals to infinity, you will get a nice value. Okay, if you put t equals to 0, what value you are getting? You are getting VL equals to VS. Correct. And this VL at t tends to infinity, this value will be 0. That means what? At the starting, when you are switching on the circuit, the inductor is fully open circuit. Inductor will work as open circuit. Okay, at t equals to 0. At t equals to 0, the inductor will work as open circuit. That's why na I equals to 0 you are getting. Okay. And since this inductor is open circuit, that's why VL equals to VS. Okay. And at t tends to infinity, when it is short circuited, that means you are not developing any kind of voltage across the inductor. That's why you are getting VL equals to 0. Okay. So let's do some examples. And first, it is given that a coil which has the inductance of 40 millihenry, a resistance of 2 ohm is connected together to form a series circuit, to form a LR series circuit or RL series circuit. Here, the voltage is 20 volt DC supply. Okay, so first you have to calculate what a steady state current. This current, okay, I am drawing one current. You have to remember this name. Okay. Okay. So from this point, the current is constant. Okay. From this point, the current you are getting as output is constant. So this time is called the steady state condition. From this T, this is your 0, this is your T1, this is your T. Okay, so from T1, this state is called steady state condition. That means in steady state condition, the inductor is not working. That's why now you are getting that steady state current. Okay. And this time duration from 0 to T1, it is called the transient state. This is called steady state. This is called transient state. It is called transient state. Okay, so total two types of states are there. One is transient, another one is steady. Okay, so that's why it is written here that final steady state current. So final steady state current means when the inductor is not at all working. It's not working. So the current will be V by R. It will be 20 by 2 equals to 10 ampere. Okay. Next one is the time constant. What is time constant? Tau equals to L by R. That means 0.04 divided by 2. Because look, here it is 40 millihenry. That means what? 40 into 10 to the power minus 3. So that means 0.04, right? 0.04. Okay, so from here 0.04 by 2. Sir, already 3 stuff hoye gache toiri. From this transient time, this is your time constant tau, that is 20 milliseconds. Okay. Now, what will be the transient time of RL series circuit? Now, transient time for RL series circuit is considered as 5 tau. Okay, this will be given that how much time the questionnaire want to know. That value will be given. Okay, so it is here 100 millisecond. Now what will be the induced EMF after 10 second? That means whatever, what is the value of voltage across the inductor, that is Vs into e to the power minus t by tau. Okay, so Vs value you already know, t value you already know, tau value you also know. So put all those values and you will get this. Okay, so today's class will be up to this. Okay, first try to absorb all this material that I am discussing, I discussed today. Okay, this will be a little bit calculative for you. So just try to understand all the topics I discussed today regarding the LR series circuit. Okay, tomorrow based on series circuit, another numericals will be discussed. Okay, previous year examples, all those examples I will discuss. Okay, so I am stopping, I am not sharing the screen now. And okay, just a minute. I have to give her attendance link. Okay, till now, is there any problem in understanding?
No, sir.
Okay.
No, sir.
So I have given the link here of Google Form. All of you give your attendances there. Okay, it will be on for 10 minutes.
Sir, where is the link, sir?
Link is given in chat box. Look.
Sir, when is college open? College open date, open. Sir.
It is already open.
Sir, offline class open.
Oh, offline class. Huh? It will be open, I think, in February.
February.
Yes, sir.
Yes?
Sir, group mein link bhejiye na.
ग्रुप में मतलब जो लोग क्लास नहीं करेंगे वो लोग भी अटेंडेंस देंगे ऐसा तो हम नहीं कर सकते
नहीं नहीं वो मतलब नहीं था सर
बस अभी
बैच में क्या है सर
अभी जो क्लास जस्ट
लिंक इज नॉट ओपनिंग
यस लिंक इज नॉट ओपनिंग ओ ऑलरेडी 11 रिस्पोंसेस आर देयर
सर बैच यस सर लेंगे अपना अपना बैच
ओके
बैच एफ2 डालेंगे सर
यस
बैच
That's true. Whatever batch you are, that will you have to give whether you are F1 or F2 or F3.
In theory, it's not allowed, sir. F1.
Okay, no problem. Whether batch you, whatever batch in batch you are, give that batch name now. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Done.
Okay.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
So everyone, give your attendances, and if given, then you may leave the meeting. Okay.
Yes, sir. Done, sir.
Okay, fine.
Bye, sir.
Okay.
Thank you. Sir, I can't able to give my attendance, sir. It's not sir. Opening.
Why it is not opening?
Sir, my call on. Sir, my call on disconnected. Please send it again.
Okay, just a minute.
Sir, when you will send the PPT file?
Actually, that's why I am taking your attendances in the chat box. This kind of problem will happen. If anyone is getting disconnected, then this problem will happen. Okay, so all of you give your attendances. Okay, so thank you everyone. You may leave the meeting if given.
Thank you, sir. It's not opening, sir. Again, it's not opening.
Okay, fine. ठीक है अगर ओपन नहीं हो रहा है तो छोड़ दो ओके मैसेज कर दो मुझे कि आई वाज देयर बस बाकी हम देख लेंगे अरे व्हाट्सएप में भेजो ना सेंड मी इन व्हाट्सएप दोज टू दोज स्टूडेंट्स हु कैन नॉट ओपन दिस गूगल फॉर्म सेंड योर अटेंडेंस इन माय व्हाट्सएप ओके
ओके सर
ओके
बाय
बाय Gracias.